相手をさせるべきだな。
やっと来ましたね。はあ、待ちくたびれました。
やはり私の先生術に間違いはありません。さあついてきてください。
おいおい、飛び込み営業
の悪いけど、そういうのいいから。
あなた、この世界の人間じゃありませんね。
なんでわかったんだ？
私が使うものこそ、ズバリ正真正銘の先生術だからです。他に質問がなければ、出発しましょう。
はあ、面倒ですね。
ゆっくり説明するので、ちゃんと聞いててくださいね。私はアストローギスト・モナ・メギストス。名前が長くて覚えにくいのでモナと呼んでください。私は先生術師。今は師匠の代わりにある箱を取り戻しにモンドへと。あれは師匠とその友人が50年前に交わした約束。
箱を取り戻すって、
それはほら、箱を保管している人と勝負するためです。師匠とその友人は生涯をかけて神秘学について競い合ってきました。ですが勝負がつかなかったそうなんです。だから正確に言うと先生術の実力と地位を証明したいんです。ですが私が占ってみたところ、師匠の友人は現在モンドにいないみたいなのです。今箱を保管しているのはその継承者。きっと私のようにその継承者も自分の師匠より優れていることでしょう。決して油断はできません。今回の勝負は何が何でも勝ちたいと色々考えた結果、あなたのことを思い出したのです。
なんで急にこいつのことを思い出したんだ？
師匠から受け継いだ知識は代々伝承していかなければなりません。もし向こうの継承者に会うとき、私が弟子を連れて行ったら、それだけで一歩リードできているじゃありませんか。それにあなたはモンドの英雄。肩書きとしては申し分なしです。だから本当の弟子じゃなくて、弟子のふりをしてくれればいいんですよ。それに私と一緒に箱を取り戻すことは、あなたにとってもメリットがあるんです。向こうの継承者に会ったら知識の交流をすることになります。そしたらあなたの運命がよりはっきり見えるようになるかもしれません。今まではっきりと見えなかったことが見えるようになるなんてこともあります。例えば
確かに国を一つずつ探していく手間が省けるぞ。
ふんふん、それこそ賢い選択です。では参りましょう。でもここを出る前にちょっと寄りたいところがあるんです。天空山に小さな宿屋があります。そこの食事は安くて美味しいのになぜか人気が出ないんです。ここ最近はそこの店主のお世話になっていたので、出発する前に
宿屋を開くなんて。人気が出ないのも当然だな。
モナさん、ちょうどいいところに来てくれました。ここへ来る途中、玉石…
玉石の指輪ですか？
どうしよう、私の大事な指輪がスライムにです。
あ、モナがいるし心配いらないだろ。彼女の先制術なら。
ダメですよ、先制術は真実を洞察して運命を見通すための由緒ある知識。むやみやたらと使うようなものじゃありません。
でもここの店主には世話になったんだろ。
これはプライド、つまり心の問題です。先制術ならどんな問題でも解決できると思っていたら、先制術師はいずれ星空に見捨てられてしまいます。結果、占いは未来を導く力を失い、二度と名門を見通せなくなります。だからこの心情を曲げることは決してできません。
そんなすごい能力を持っていて金儲けに使わないなんてもったいないな。
はあ、協力してくれたらお礼に2万モラを用意していたんですが。
に、2万ですか？
いえ、なんでもありませんよ。ただこうも簡単に2万モラが手に入るなんて、指輪を拾った人はラッキーだなと思っただけです。
ごほん、それはそうですが、でも店主が汗水垂らして稼いだお金を出してまで探した指輪です。きっと何か特別な思い入れがあるのでしょう。このまま放っておくのもよくありませんね。うん、探してあげましょう。先制術を使わなくともきっと方法があるはずです。
モナの考えがなんとなく読めてきたぞ。
この件はあなたに任せます。これは師匠から弟子への最初の任務です。
うーん、スライムに飲み込まれたっていうなら、元素の餌で周りのスライムを誘い出してみるか。覚えてるか、ディリュックの旦那のとこで生成した元素の餌。
実はちょっとくすねておいたんだ。
なあ、細かいことは気にするな。
何か策があるみたいですね。
おう、すぐ戻るから待っとけ。元素の餌の効果はすごいから、この辺りのスライムを一気に誘い出せるぞ。ただスライムも数が多いと危険だからな。ちゃんと準備し。
Thank you. That's it.
You actually found it. Not Mr. Zhu, you must take care of such precious things a bit better. You might not be so fortunate next time.
You're absolutely right. How would I have faced my family if I had lost the 253rd ring my mother gave me? Let me explain. My family owns 3 jade mines, and in order to ensure that I would be able to find myself a good wife, my mother had many jade accessories made as heirlooms. I think there might be over 500 of them.
Then why would you feel the need to set up an inn here?
Well, inheriting the family business too early unavoidably made things boring. Thank you, all the same. Here's the mora, as agreed. Please take it.
Then I'll take it, gladly.
But we did all the work!
A disciple should act like one. How can they steal their master's thunder?
Didn't we say we were just playing pretend?
Well, you need to start practicing now. If my rival is as smart as I think they are, they will figure you out in a heartbeat.
What was that rumbling sound?
Oh, right. You mustn't have eaten in days. I'm very sorry. I forgot that you have no...
That didn't happen. Forget it. Well, I suddenly feel that you have indeed contributed to our good fortune. I say we spend this money on treating you to a fine meal. If we travel north, we'll reach the Wangshu Inn. I hear the food there is really good, so let's go try it out. No need to thank me. I'm just doing as a good master should.
Did she say she was treating us? Is Paimon hearing things? Let's go after her for good food!
Ha!
Since it's Mona's treat, we can order whatever we want, right?
Of course. I am a most generous master, after all. Excuse me, what would you like to order? It's exactly what it says on the label. Abalone made from vegetarian ingredients. It's just as good as the real thing. These are made using large succulent shrimp wrapped in crispy fried potatoes. They have an amazing texture. Though tofu could not be a more ordinary ingredient, it and crab roe are truly a match made in heaven. It's one of our special... This is a favorite among our regulars. Bamboo shoots, meat, and ham are cooked together, creating a richly flavored soup. Pour a few spoonfuls into each...
All of them? We only have three... No, two and a half people? Isn't that too much food?
That's not how you count it! Besides, Paimon hasn't even ordered yet! Squirrelfish, Juyu chili chicken, and Juri soup, please!
Sure! And is there anything else you'd like to order, ma'am?
I'd just like to ask, how much do the current dishes cost in total?
Around 20,000 mora.
Then, I'll just have some vegetarian noodles, please.
Paimon's been thinking about something since we started eating. Is it? Because she actually doesn't have money?
I heard that. I said I was treating. How could I be rattled by something as mundane as Mora?
An astrologist's mind is set on studying the stars. Being so easily disturbed by such as would hamper my judgment, especially the act of overly gratifying oneself using Mora. It is both vulgar and dangerous.
So, not eating the dishes we ordered is also part of an astrologist's pride? Paimon doesn't get it, but it feels kinda bad that only we got to feast. Oh yes, we can do that. Just give us a minute. You don't use Mora to fulfill your desires, so it's fine as long as you're not buying anything, right? Let's go borrow the kitchen from the innkeeper!
Hello. How may I help?
We'd like to borrow the kitchen here.
Ah, I see. If I may add one more thing. Talent from your clothes, you're most likely not from around these parts. But since you've come to Liyue, would you like to try making Liyue-style cuisine? I have a recipe for golden crab with me. It's a Yue cuisine classic. It's crab meat that's been rolled in flour, deep-fried, and then pan-fried together with ginger and garlic. When you finally played up, the crab seems to be lying on gold.
Golden crab.
Golden crab! Golden crab!
Then let's get to it. With your skills in the kitchen, this'll be a cinch.
Howdy. Please.
Ugh, too salty.
You should really bring the Knights of Favonius with you next time.
Too salty.
Huh.
I still have a lot to do at the guild. How about you take a rest while I go...
There's no need to spend all that effort on me. I'm not in dire need. I am a little hungry. But it's not a big deal. This aroma is... I never thought it'd be so luxurious. Fine. Since my disciple has put in so much time and effort, I must, with great difficulty, accept. This golden crab is too delicious. I have never eaten anything this good in my life. I never knew that my disciple was this skilled. As your master, I am most comforted. I see that it's no boast to call them Liyue's delicacies. Much to spend all this mora on? Ah, it's nothing. Nothing at all. Now that we've eaten and drank our fill, we should be off. If we travel north from here, we should reach the Stone Gate, and from there we will be within the boundaries of Mondstadt. What deep mysteries shall we acquire knowledge of?
was tiring, but we're finally in Mondstadt. The quest to plumb the wondrous depths of knowledge is indeed arduous.
Paimon's not tired.
That's because...
Well, it doesn't look like an astrologist is all that amazing either.
That's because you have too many unrealistic fantasies about astrology.
Are you also resting your feet here?
Who are you?
Oh, my brothers and I are all merchants. We just finished doing business in Liyue, and we're preparing to head back to Mondstadt. You look rather tired. The cart we hired will be coming in a while. What say you to coming along? No need, no need. We're already heading that way anyway.
There's no need. Now, shoo, get out of our way.
Miss, is there something wrong?
Cease your pretensions, bandit. Picking up people on the road who appear vulnerable, robbing them blind once they've gotten on the cart, and then taking them to some Archon-forsaken place. Is that your deal?
What are you saying? We came over here to make conversation, and this is how we're rewarded? With insults? If you don't want to get on, don't. Crazy girl.
Well then, shall I tell you now which objects you have on you that are stolen? If you have any quibbles, we can bring people to corroborate what I've said and all will come to light. If I lose, I'll pay you 20,000 mora. But if I win, then you'll be eating prison rations in Liyue Harbor tonight. How about it? If you're real legitimate businessmen, there's nothing to fear, is there?
You've pushed it too far, brat. I don't know how you found out, but as long as we get rid of you, no one will have to know.
You will not touch her.
Don't fret, it's just a few bandits. You said earlier that there was nothing amazing about astrologists. Well then, this is a good time to show you what your master can do.
All right, baby. I'll blow you away! Run!
Let me scry.
There's no end to this.
Written in the stars. What did you think? Did that satisfy your expectations? Such things are elementary for an astrologist. Lies are worthless before astrology. Destiny and truth are written in the stars. Though it may take more time to garner the specifics, I can read the gist of a situation at a glance.
But you did hit some bumps in the road.
That's because Teyvat's stars can only display the fates and truths of this world. Anything related to you becomes like a fog that even I cannot penetrate. That is why I must meet that successor. With our knowledge combined, I might be able to gain new insight into your fate. Whatever the case, you've got everything to gain from this trip. All right, I'm rested. Let's get this journey to Mondstadt over with.
If only we had a cart.
I thought you weren't tired. Are you ready? Don't shame your master now. We're about to meet that successor. I guess... Wait, no. It won't do if you have no idea at all, even if you are a fake disciple. We have a rule that forbids us from teaching outsiders, but I suppose I could teach you. My astrology is based on hydromancy, and as the name suggests, I use the reflections in water bodies to observe the true starry sky. Allow me to demonstrate. Watch closely now. From the present station and movement of the stars... I see. So that successor is a young, female Knight of Favonius.
Doesn't that sound like Lisa?
We will meet her here presently. Well, that's all the information we need. It seems that even basic astrology can't be grasped in one go. Never mind, I'll explain in detail later. She's here.
Wow, it's you, Miss Honorary Knight. And Paimon, too, you're back!
That's her. The successor to great knowledge.
Successor?
That's right. I am the astrologist who has plumbed the depths of the ocean of stars. Surely you have long calculated my arrival as well.
An ocean of stars? What's that? Does it have fish in it?
Fish? No, don't play dumb. Is this some kind of game?
I should be the one saying that. I didn't get what you said at all.
But my predictions can't be mistaken. Well, let's make sure. Your mother's name is Alice, isn't it?
That's right. Oh, so you're mommy's friend. But
my readings told me as much. But before she left, she must have imparted her mystical arts to you, surely.
Mystical arts? I don't get it. Mommy only taught me to make jumpy dumpties.
So Glee's mother is the friend and rival of Mona's teacher?
Yes. As well versed in astrology as she was, my master knew only astrology. Alice, on the other hand, was skilled in a great many other mystical fields.
Well, Glee's so young. So even if she'd heard this deep knowledge, she might not have understood.
Yes. It seems she has inherited the blood, but not the knowledge. What a miscalculation. There can be no contest like this. Yes. So before Alice left, did she tell you about a 50-year agreement and about a certain box?
Oh, I know this one. So you're here for that box. I'll look. Wait here. Not this one. Or this one. No, it's not this one either. Ah, I remember now. I buried it together with my new treasure at Windrise. Wait for me. I'll be right back.
Glee, don't just run off. Don't you need the things in your pack?
I'll help her pack these things back in. You go after her. Looking at how rash she is, I worry for the box.
In the explosions.
Retrieval complete! Let's bring it back!
Hi.
You're back at last. The wait was exceedingly dull. I had intended to read a book to pass the time. It dropped from Klee's backpack, so I thought it might contain some ancient knowledge, but... Never mind, Matt. So, did you find the box?
We did. It's in perfect shape.
That's wonderful! Wait a moment. Why isn't it locked? And why is it empty?
Huh? Well, it's because I borrowed this box to store my treasures.
Borrowed?
But since you're here for the box, I took all my treasures out. That's why it's empty.
You used it to store your things? Then where are the original contents of the box? That's what I want.
Oh, you want the thing that used to be in the box? You should have said so.
You haven't broken it, have you?
No, it's not broken at all. It's the book in your hand.
What? This. So this book, this diary, is that hag's... It's her diary from 50 years ago? The thing she wanted back after 50 years was the dark history of her youth? I'm finished. No wonder that old woman said I should not look at it no matter what or she'd rip me to shreds.
Am I in trouble? It was you who said you wanted the box. You didn't say anything about the thing inside. I don't know anything. I'm leaving. Bye.
Well, if you don't say anything, your master won't find out, will she?
Impossible. Astrology can see through all lies. You've seen it yourself. Oh. After having spent all my mora to come to Mondstadt, not only have I gained no knowledge, but now I can't return. How did it come to this?
That's so sad. Maybe you could forget everything in that book and then go back.
That's... too difficult. And even if I wanted to stay in Mondstadt, it would be... Yes, I mean no. You really have no way with words.
Well, then you'll just have to go back and face your master.
Stop talking about it. I guess I'll have to... I'll just have to stay in Mondstadt temporarily. Once that old crone's reached the end of her days, I'll be free. But what will I do about my astrology research? No, wait, I don't even have a place to stay.
About that, we can go ask Catherine at the Adventurers Guild. Let's see if she can help.
The Adventurers Guild? Ah, right. You can do commissions for them in exchange for... You know what I mean, don't you? Thanks, I... Never mind, it's nothing.
I see. I understand the situation. There is a magic laboratory in Mondstadt that has been sealed by some unknown person. Although we have a few specialists who could break the seal, they all have their own labs and aren't that interested in the matter. I believe that if the astrologist you mentioned can break the seal, the owner of that house wouldn't mind if she stayed there. All right. Then, allow me to tell you where the house is.
Go, Barbara, go!
The person who placed this seal is by no means simple. Breaking this seal by force is nigh on impossible. Interesting. I suppose it's worth using my astrology on. Let me see. I see. So, if you first, and then you...
Oh, shit.
Wow. All right, it's open.
Holy moly, that's amazing! Now we
we just need to go back to Catherine and you'll be able to stay here.
No need, no need. You have my utmost thanks.
You are?
Oh, I'm Goth, the owner of this house. I passed by the Adventurers Guild a while back and Catherine told me about the matter. I never thought this troublesome seal would be dispelled so quickly.
Does that mean I can stay here?
Of course, of course. The facilities inside were just being left there anyway. I would be glad to have someone make use of them. To express my thanks, I shall rent this building to you at the lowest possible price.
Rent? I didn't hear anything about rent, and I helped out too.
Yes, of course, I understand. I am most thankful to you for that. So rest assured that I will give you the best rates.
I mean...
Paimon thinks Mona's misunderstood something, but...
I guess I don't have any other choice. I'll rent this place.
Great! Then we are agreed. I will go prepare the documentation. Please wait here.
Thanks for your help. Also, well, I'm very sorry, but I won't be able to do what I agreed to help you with just yet. Without the necessary tools and without new knowledge, it will take me some time to see your destiny clearly. But I promise that I'll do a reading for you first thing once I'm ready. Thank you. Our traveling together was fate. And of the good kind, I'd say. I wish you both safe travels. As for me, I need to think of the future as well.
How is she gonna make a living if she doesn't use astrology to make money? Maybe we should come back and check on her once in a while. It would really be bad if she fainted from hunger in there.
Yes, give me my extra.
Nice and spicy! Go, Barbara, go!
I got more loot. I saved all my quests just so I could hit level 40 on the quick. Look at this shit, bro. Controller! Omega Lull! Bruh. Are you fucking kidding me, dude?
All things must change. It's nothing. I just thought it a great shame that so many of these glazed lilies have wilted.
What happened to them?
Back in my day, people said that glazed lilies can read human hearts. If they heard beautiful sounds like laughter and singing, they would also bloom joyfully. But if they heard too much wild gossip or slander, they would quickly wither away.
So that means these flowers feel what's happening in Lilith?
Yes. The rumors of Rex Lapis's death are no small matter. They are everywhere. Some say it was a Fatui plot. Others say that the Qixing made it all up, and still others think that That which lies in the deep is breaking free. This harbor is like a mountain of dry tinder. One spark, and the fire will consume us all. Well, I shall say no more. This old woman's grown too old and naggy. Did you have something to say, youngster? Borrow something? Oh, you've come to borrow the cleansing bell, yes? Apart from that, I don't have anything of value that you youngsters might want, but it won't either. That trinket used to belong to a friend of mine. I was a vain beauty when I was young, and I would pester him for that bell all the time. He could not dissuade me, and so he gave it to me. But he said that if someone should come to borrow it, I must not be loath to give it away. It has been many years, and who knows how many times someone has come to borrow this bell. Still, though, I can't recall when it started. It's been a long time since anyone has come to borrow it. Oh, these old bones are so slow to look for things. I doubt you can wait that long.
What a weird thing to be proud of.
All right, children. There is no need to worry. I didn't place the bell very far away.
Do you live near here, Granny? Whoa, but this is Yujing Terrace. It's gotta be expensive.
Oh, an old lady like me can't afford to buy a place in this city. See this ceramic teapot? My entire household is in here.
How does that work? Hey, that's rude! And even if it was like that, it must be a very expensive bell, right, Granny?
Oh, youngsters. I simply mean that the bell is somewhere inside this teapot, and you are quite welcome to borrow it. If you can find it.
This granny's so weird. What does she mean, her whole household? Is she playing with us?
Youngsters, this is where this old woman keeps all her things. Quickly now, go fetch that bell.
Whoa! That sounds like Granny's voice! So, this is her teapot? What's going on?
Oh dear, so many cobwebs. It seems I really haven't cleaned it in a long while. Sorry to trouble you, children. Please help an old lady clean up.
Adeptus?
Barbara, go!
We had one of these too. Or at least we wouldn't have to camp outside.
Let the show begin!
Oh, you found it. The youngsters are so quick on their feet. Oh, now, let me see. How did this opening work again? Oh, dear. All right, that'll do. Come on out now, children. In and out in no time. You youngsters really are quick. The Fatui? Child, what goes on in that mind of yours, I wonder? I'm far too old to be quibbling with them. But if they overreach themselves, I will do what I must.
Paimon kinda knows what you mean. But the confused. Are you really giving us the bell just like that, Granny? Don't you think it's weird? Something's just happened to Rex Lapis, and then we come running up asking for it?
Oh, don't be silly. Liyue Harbor has been through a great deal in its history. In that time, it has seen the departure of countless Adepti. But no matter what, we have always performed the rite of parting first before any other matters. To cry, catch the murderer at the top of one's lungs, but ignore the rite of parting. That, to me, is what is wrong-headed. Now that you have come to borrow the bell, I guess that perhaps an old friend of mine has finally decided to take matters into their own hands. So, why would I be unwilling to lend you the bell?
It belongs to Granny. We're supposed to return what we borrow.
Oh, let you keep it. You really are a frank child. If you want it, you can keep it. But this bell gets homesick sometimes. Who knows? It might find its way back into these old hands. Well, you must have things to do. Since you have the bell, you should return. Oh, and do tell the person who sent you that
If they have time, they can come over for tea. I don't have much to offer, but you can always count on an old lady for a pot of tea.
We will. Thanks, Granny.
Let's dance!
I can't wait to see my adorable daughter again.
Let's dance!
Indeed, this is the cleansing bell. It's in. Let's place the perfume we've prepared inside. An adeptus.
That's suspicious. But if you don't want to talk about it, we won't pry. Oh, yes, that old granny asked us to tell you something. If you have the time, you can come over for tea. I don't have much to offer, but you can always count on an old lady for a pot of tea.
That tone does not suit you. Still, her teapot is indeed very good. There are none better for brewing tea. When a suitable time arrives, I'll bring a spot of fine tea and pay her a visit.
So what's the next step in our preparations?
Next, we need to purchase kites.
Ooh, Paimon loves kites! Are you taking us kite flying? Is this our break time?
No. Kites are children's toys, yes. But they also play various symbolic roles in Liyue's rituals. I will explain it to you. But our next course of action should probably be to purchase the kites first.
Oh, sure. Curiouser and curiouser.
You're here. The 7 kites you asked for have been made to order. Would you like to take them now?
Yes, thank you.
It's rare to see customers who want to buy this type of kite nowadays. In the early days, we used to get orders from people of all walks of life.
Well, this is Mr. Zhang Li from the Wangsheng Funeral Parlor. So he's probably well-versed in all these walks of life. We've talked about a whole bunch of things while traveling with him. He seems to know Liyue's favorite topics, money and government, really well. But he likes talking about less useful topics instead.
Well, that's because I prefer to share fun things with you.
Children's toys are very fun things, that's for sure. I enjoy watching the children at play as much as anyone else. But there is more to it than that. Finely crafted toys are well loved by children, but this craft itself has been honed over thousands of years, and there is meaning behind that. I have made kites in Liyue for 40 years, and I am intimately familiar with the forms passed down from my ancestors. The meaning of these seven kites is far from banal.
Indeed. These are decorations used in the rite of parting. The seven kites represent the seven.
I took the liberty of coloring outside the lines when doing the insignia of the Animo Archon. As for the kite that honors the Geo Archon, one must follow the contract given right down to the last letter. These patterns are ancient, and you can also find them in the Golden House.
Ah, Paimon's heard that name before. Huh?
The design of this kite displays a firm grasp on the cyclicality and eternity so dear to the Electro Archon. These markings of tree and leaf pay due honor to wisdom and the passage of time. All the justice flows across the surface of the waters. War rages like a flame, as does that which the Cryo Archon once.
The compliments of a learned man truly are pleasant.
Well then, Granny Shan, I shall take these back with me. As for the payment...
Well, allow me.
Hey, it's Child!
No, I was merely passing through. I see Mr. Zhang Li's the same as ever. When paying, well, when getting others to pay for him, he neither looks at the price tag nor his wallet. He knows a great deal about money, and about the trials of the common man. He just doesn't consider poverty to be something that could ever happen to him. Or perhaps, you could say that he cannot imagine himself lacking money.
How has he not died of hunger yet?
Child, you are as fond of jokes as ever. Well then, since we've purchased our kites without incident, there's no need to take a break before moving to the next step in our preparations. The rite of parting requires helping hands as well as materials. We should be able to find some people near the harbor.
Oh, by the way, take this bag of money. You probably won't want to let Zhang Li do the bargaining, if you know what I mean. Seems I missed out on some interesting information. I suppose I'll just have to find a more opportune moment next time.
Let the show begin!
Oh, help? Sure. I, Tick, always put in 100% effort into everything I do. Of course, there'll be a premium if you want me to give 110%. So what's the job?
Let me see. We are still missing some wooden implements over at Yujing Terrace. They aren't uncommon objects, so I didn't make any special preparations for them.
No problem. That'll be 20,000 mora for a single trip. How does that sound?
Done.
Let me think. deal. This price is reasonable. I'll hop right to it.
I'll protect the pearl.
A full day of odd jobs at Yujing Terrace. No problem. 25,000 per day. A fair trade, yes?
Whoa, that's expensive. Could you give us a bit of a discount on account of the whole Hero of Mondstadt thing?
Hero of Mondstadt? Never heard of them.
Well, you may never have heard of this hero, but it seems you've heard of Mora nonetheless. Thus, I will simply pay the whole sum.
This price'll do. No loss to me for a day's work.
Hiring help? Sure. But let me just say first that I'm a reserve member of the Adventurers Guild. I take adventuring commissions, but I don't do anything clerical.
Adventure? Venturing into the mountains to capture a few crystal flies seems adventurous enough.
Eh? That's not hard. Almost a bit too easy for a reserve adventurer. Never mind. I'll only charge you 15,000, Mora. What say you?
A most fair price.
Five geocrystal flies. Yes, I do think it's worth about this much. I'll do it.
Made another handsome sum today.
All finished then? Splendid. Any leftover cash is yours to keep. A favor for the Fatui should never go unrewarded.
You think you can buy us off with some loose change? No way! Paimon demands to know when the next payment is coming!
Well, how does this sound? You give me the information I need, and maybe I'll leave the Northland Bank's vaults open and unattended for half an hour.
What info do you need? Huh. Does that mean you know what he's after? Yikes! You're right! Signora!
You both need to calm down. I don't know what's gotten into you. Just what is this about? The atmosphere got so tense all of a sudden.
Next, we need some everlasting incense. For this, we need to go to Boo Boo Pharmacy, the finest pharmacy in all of... Is everything okay?
Everything is fine. I was just informing them that they need not return the surplus mora. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must be going.
Paimon definitely felt like Child wasn't happy with us just now.
To Boo Boo Pharmacy.
Huh? Did you hear that? Where did it come from?
The reception, it seems.
go check it out, and Paimon will bring up the rear.
So many medicines, but no cure for heartache.
Oh, there you are! But you can't even reach the counter! Ah, Paimon thinks you might be right! Look at the talisman on her forehead!
Welcome to Boo Boo Pharmacy. I am Chi-Chi. Once upon a time, Chi-Chi died. Then, Chi-Chi was saved by the Adepti. Now, Chi-Chi is a zombie.
Something like this would be unimaginable in Mondstadt.
Hello, little girl. Do you sell everlasting incense here?
Excuse me, sir. Did you bring your prescription?
Surely no prescription is needed to purchase everlasting incense. It's not a controlled substance.
Chi-Chi can get your medicine, but only if you show Chi-Chi your prescription. These are Chi-Chi's orders from Chi-Chi.
Zombies are limited to acting within the confines of their orders. And somehow in this case, the zombie issues her own orders to herself. My dear Chi-Chi, we didn't bring a prescription, I'm afraid. But we do hope that you can still help us find some everlasting incense.
Okay, then.
How did you manage that?
But Chi-Chi helps you. You help Chi-Chi. Only fair.
Since when do customers need to do favors for customer service staff?
Never mind. Just think of it as a peer-to-peer transaction. That way, everybody wins. Sometimes in Liyue, the art of the deal is simply about victory via mental gymnastics.
Go to Mount Tianheng, find the Guizhong Ballista, and hunt a cocoa goat. Please and thank you.
Guizhong Ballista. I have heard of this device before. It's a kind of crossbow turret, installed on Mount Qinhong by an adeptus in the distant past. An early mechanical device. Located in Qinhong Pass, it was designed to automatically fire at large monsters, protecting Liyue from external threats.
Mr. Zhang Li really knows Liyue inside out.
Apparently not quite. This is the first I have ever heard of the cocoa goat.
The cocoa goat is a legendary animal. An adeptabeast.
Did you want to add anything else, or...?
No. Just that the cocoa goat is a legendary animal. An adeptabeast. What it looks like. Don't know. Where to find it? Don't know either. Where it came from? Also don't know.
Very well then. Let's start by investigating near the Guizhong Ballista. Perhaps we will find some clues.
What the heck is a cocoa goat?
So many medicines, but no cure for heartache.
Thank you.
strong link to the charm.
Let the show begin!
Thank you.
Guess we can rest a bit. Guess we can rest a bit. I still have a lot to do at the guild. How about you take a rest while I go back?
Can totally believe
took an Adeptus to build this. But how do you operate this thing? Just think how much strength you would need.
It is currently inoperable in any case. This device is broken. After millennia of wear and tear, even Adepti contraptions are difficult to maintain.
So what are we gonna do? Quick, Mr. Zhongli, use your unlimited high society knowledge powers!
You almost make it sound like I'm some sort of bourgeois parasite whose only utility lies in providing quaint pieces of trivia on demand. That said, let me think for a moment. Ah, yes. Spare parts were made for the Guizhong Ballista when it was first built, in case it was damaged in battle. As I recall, there is a military supply post from that period somewhere inside the pass. If we can retrieve the spare parts from where they are stored, we may be able to repair the Guizhong Ballista. One just needs to understand the basic working principles of the device.
So, what you're saying is that you actually understand the working principles?
I have a smattering of knowledge on the topic.
I literally could have fucking hit AR.
With the parts in hand, I could at least tinker with it. These parts look useful. One moment. I will try to repair the device. It is done. The Guizhong ballista is more intricately designed than I thought.
Ooh! Now how do we turn it on?
It's easy enough. We simply need to do this. Look, it even has a scope.
Just what do you think you're doing? So you fixed up this turret because you're planning to do what exactly?
Not a turret. A Guizhong ballista. Also, kindly state your name before you ask a question. It's just...
Are you blind or something? You're looking at the leader of the treasure hoarders, old man. This area is supposed to be chock full of hidden treasures. But you can't get anywhere near them with this thing keeping watch. It might look like any other mechanical device, but trust me, it's got a mind of its own. Last time we approached the mountain, it nearly skewered one of our guys. A few of us risked our lives to disarm it, which amazingly we managed. And then we turn our backs for 2 seconds, and you've already gone and repaired it? The next thing you'll be repairing is your faces! And that's if you get out of this alive!
Tut tut. Vandalizing the legacy of an Adeptus for selfish gain. Disgraceful behavior. It is not we who need reprimanding. But you.
There's no way to this. You're open,
boss.
You're open.
Another test subject. The wrong test subject. That tingle?
Let's dance!
Burn! The hunted. Becomes the hunted.
Troubling ourselves over this rabble is not worth the time. We should focus on our contract with Chi-Chi.
Oh, yeah, that! So we've got the Guizhong.
Ajung Ballista working, but where's our Coca Goat?
A search using the Guizhong Ballista revealed no significant life forms nearby, save for the usual wildlife. What's more, a contraption built using Adeptus technology should have no trouble detecting an Adeptabeast, as Chi-Chi put it.
Which means... a Paimon wouldn't go that far. We did something positive, right?
We won't solve anything while standing here and racking our brains. Let's return to Boo Boo Pharmacy, explain that we could not find a Cocoa Goat, and review our next step.
Good idea. We did our best, and that's what counts.
Forgive us. We were unable to fulfill our end of the contract. We found no trace of the Cocoa Goat Adeptabeast of which you speak.
What a disappointment. Don't worry about it. But I feel very disappointed.
Aw, poor Chi-Chi. Why does Paimon feel so guilty all of a sudden?
Cocoa Goat milk is tasty. So tasty. Much better than normal goat milk. Only an Adeptabeast could make such tasty milk. I'm sorry. I have a poor memory. I cannot remember the name of the milk. That's why I wrote it down. Where did I put it? Ah, here. This is the name. Coconut milk.
Huh?
I owe you both an apology. I hastily agreed to what appeared to be an equitable agreement with this zombie child, when perhaps I should have undertaken further due diligence.
Never mind, Zhongli. You didn't know. As the Liyue proverb goes, all things are random and... So how are you supposed to predict anything? Literally no one could have seen this coming.
Excuse me, everyone. Did Chi-Chi say a bad thing?
Oh, sorry, but Paimon's gonna leave the job of shattering this poor kiddo's world to you.
No. Impossible.
Seems Chi-Chi took this pretty hard.
Someone learnt a valuable life lesson today, then. Thank you all for looking after my little Chi-Chi.
Might I ask who?
Ah, how rude of me. I'm Baiju, boss of the Boo Boo Pharmacy.
Paimon thought Chi-Chi was the boss. Turns out it's some more ingredients around his neck.
What a sorry state of affairs. This little mascot is even more of a simpleton than Chi-Chi.
Ah! The snake
prefer to stay silent, but faced with strangers, I must speak, lest you mistake me for an escapee from the medicine cabinet, for I am a living, breathing serpent!
Don't mind Chengsheng. She's a good girl, really. As for you three, communal chaos causing with Chi-Chi aside, what business brings you here?
Do you sell everlasting incense in this fine establishment?
Everlasting incense? Why, of course we do.
Whew, at last! Things are finally starting to come together.
3 million mora. Top quality. Guaranteed.
You might as well just rob the Golden House. Oh, but the chasing have taken it over for now. Security will be tighter than usual.
Hmm. 3 million. An innocuous number in and of itself, though practically speaking, it could be a hard sum to come by.
It's a crazy number! We'd never be able to make that much, Mora! And as for Mr. Zhang Li, he's around 3 million short.
This is correct.
What are we gonna do? Is this the part where we go crawling back to child?
Coco Goat! Coco Goat! My sides hurt. Oh my goodness, I cannot believe you fell for that.
Hey, less laughter, more sympathy!
I'm almost in tears over here. Thank you. That was the best laugh I've had in a long time. In return, I'm more than happy to sort out this mess you've managed to get yourselves into. Excuse me, sir. Dr. Baiju, isn't it? Truly honored. I'm Child, one of the Fatui Harbingers. Forgive my audacity, but I see a great many opportunities for us to collaborate in the future. If Boo Boo Pharmacy needed a stable supply of, say, coconut milk, the Fatui could help by setting up a robust and speedy distribution network.
Strange. I knew the Fatui infiltrated businesses with seductive deals, but so much fuss over coconut milk?
Coconut milk. Baiju, quick. Chi-Chi wants coconut milk.
Ah, yes, of course, Chi-Chi. Anything you want. Thank you, Child. I look forward to a successful collaboration in the future. I can give you a discount on that everlasting incense, too. Let's say 2,990,000 mora.
That's like zero difference from 3 million!
Hmm. 2,990,000. Also an innocuous number in and of itself. Though practically speaking, it is a whole 10,000 less than the original sum of 3 million. Well, now that this is settled, we must head back to Yujing Terrace. Mr. Child, Dr. Baiju, little Miss Chi-Chi, see you soon.
Ah, that lot is an absolute riot. Honestly, I can't remember the last time I laughed so hard. So, you've been eavesdropping, I hope. What have I missed?
Yes, Master Child. They spoke of the Qixing taking the Golden House.
Well, well, well. Ningguang and her Qixing cronies. What else would they be hiding in the Golden House, if not the Exuvia? I apologize, but I warned you, didn't I? As the old Liu saying goes, the walls have ears.
can't. You have 2 seconds to tell me what.
Well, as it stands, we've hired helpers, and we've acquired the Everlasting Incense. The completion of our preparations is not far off.
Woo! Finally!
Well, Traveler, have you gained anything from our adventure so far? Odd? Which is it, I wonder? The questions that such travels raise are ever so complicated. Well, I'll leave you to ruminate over it yourself. As to remuneration for your help, to treat you to a meal. Yes, don't worry. I'm bringing the Mora this time. Tonight, I shall take you both to an old hole in the wall, praised throughout Liyue.
Hole in the wall? As in a cool restaurant?
Indeed. Let us meet near the harbor, at third round knockout.
Fortune find you.
I'll protect her.
I wonder when I'll be as tall as my big sis.
Thank you.